how you started up everything, sir?
As a software engineer, many people say that there will be a lot of stress. Software field means stressful field. Meditation, which I am doing on a regular basis, is helping me to last almost 16 years and never had any stress. There are no challenges or no tension, no worry at all in my job.
Prakriti Uma Mahesh is an author, global speaker, spiritual scientist, and a leading spiritualist who has transformed millions of lives through his meditative and spiritual activities over the last 25 years. He preaches spirituality as science that focuses on spiritual lifestyle, and it helps humans to live life wonderfully, successfully, comfortably, and easily.
Why I was reading Osho books? Because I was in depression because of ragging and all. I was thinking to commit suicide. I cannot show my face because...
With his more than 4,000 quotations and more than 400 videos, he has helped youth to achieve their goals and also help them to be confident and happy. He is also the author of Amazon best-selling book, Think Differently, which has been found very useful to be happy anytime, anywhere.
How you can celebrate your life wherever you are, whatever you are. You may be worst fellow, you may be useless fellow, you may be the top worst fellow in this world, but still you are a Buddha.
The founder of Prakriti Meditation, Uma Mahesh, is a veteran with 20 years of corporate experience. By profession, he is a software engineer at Persistent Software Company.
And I feel there is no other such guru in this world like Prakriti.
He has been awarded with Indian Excellency Award by Indian Book of Records for motivational services. Please join me in welcoming Prakriti Uma Mahesh only on BMC English.
Namaste. Welcome to Be a Master. Welcome, sir. Welcome to the show.
So thank you very much.
You mentioned one point, introspection. Okay. People may find faults in one's own self. Okay. But they don't change. So first we need to accept faults or emotions or whatever way we are, then next step comes changing or whatever. So I think acceptance plays a crucial role here.
So if you find fault in yourself, you need not feel guilty. Normally people accept and go into superiority complex, or they go into inferiority complex. Both are wrong. You should not accept and go into superiority, oh no problem chalega. It is not correct. You should accept and take a step to transform yourself. If you are not taking any step, that is of no use in accepting. The self-transformation is the way. Self-transformation comes from replacing the wrong thoughts with the right thoughts, wrong behavior with the right behavior, wrong way of talking with the right way of talking. You should replace. You need not feel guilty or you need not feel inferior. Inferiority complex is again a wrong way. Superiority complex is also a wrong way.
So you say both these are different, two faces of ego.
Yes. Inferiority complex is also ego. Many people think that it is not ego. Yes. That is also ego. As you are not able to become superior, you feel inferior. Is the other side of the same coin. Yes.
So, you know, pride. Generally we get ego is something, pride, something this in this way. But no, feeling guilty, feeling inferior, this is also another face of ego.
Another side of the same coin, same ego.
Yes. So you should balance both the faces. Sir, you have started one meditation, that is Prakriti Meditation. So tell us about that. What made you start this particular meditation? How it is different?
It is not different. It is more or less same. Earlier, when I started the meditation in 1995, there are few pyramids. One pyramid was in Karnool, another pyramid was in Anantapur and Guntakal, like that, two to three pyramids only. So when I have to do more meditation, I used to go to mountains or forest. I used to go to Prakriti, nature. And there I used to go and do meditation day and night. I used to go to Srisalam forest for 10 days, 15 days and go inside. So, just like pyramid meditation, it is just like doing meditation in Prakriti, that's all. Okay. If you do meditation in Prakriti or nature, you will be able to get concentration or energy very easily compared to doing meditation at home. Compared to doing meditation at home, if you do meditation in pyramid, that will give more energy. In the same way, do meditation in nature also, in Prakriti also. Along with that, even if you don't do meditation also, you just relax in nature. Just go and relax and watch whatever is happening in nature. Observe the trees, be with the trees, be with the plants, be with the animals, be with the sky, be with sunset, be with sunrise. Just be with that, do nothing. Don't play or do nothing. You will get lot of energy. That's what I observed. So being with nature is Prakriti meditation.
What did you learn or inspired from nature or trees or whatever?
It is not like direct learning. Say when I do meditation, I used to feel energy from inside. In the same way, when I go and used to be with nature, I used to see that same energy came. Okay. I observed the energy levels increasing in my inner self. And I observed natural intelligence increasing in me. Just like birds. Birds don't know any way. They go here and there in total day, and by evening they will go directly to their nest.
Yes.
They don't have any route map, but still they go perfectly. That means that is a natural intelligence. They will build their house, that is nest, without any knowledge. How? That is what is natural wisdom. Natural intelligence. That has increased me in me. I observe, I used to do lot of unknown things. I don't know, say now I have written a book. I don't know how to write a book, but still I have written a book. Naturally, it is flowing through me. If you do knowing things, that is okay. Unknown things also you will be able to do. Even if you don't know it, through intuition, through some messages coming from some unknown source, universe, you will be able to do lot of things. That intuition or natural intelligence increased a lot.
This meditation is nothing but spending some time in nature,
yes,
alone.
Or doing our anapanasati only.
This is what one of the principle in 18 guiding principles,
yes,
we have this. Should spend enough time in nature.
Yes. That is taught to me by Patriji only.
Yes, yes. So nothing different.
No, it is not different.
Okay. How it is helping? So you practiced your meditation spending in nature or forest or whatever, and we do meditation in our own house. So how different will be the environment?
So if you sit in house and do meditation, you may be getting lot of thoughts. Many people, if they get more thoughts, they don't sit. They'll just skip meditation.
Yes.
So if you are not able to do meditation, you just go and relax in nature. Say after half an hour or 1 hour, your eyes will be closed naturally. Without your own intention also, they will be closed and you will go into deep meditation. If you are not able to concentrate, just go and relax in nature. Just relax, do nothing, even don't do meditation also. After half an hour or 1 hour, your eyes will be naturally closed, you will go into deep meditation. That is what I observed. So in that earlier stage, I used to get lot of thoughts, hundreds of thoughts, thousands of thoughts. I was unable to focus in meditation. So when I went and spent some time in meditation, I got this experience.
Yes.
My focus increased in meditation. Naturally, I went into meditation, naturally, without any force.
So in our house, we have the regular thoughts or in the environment, the atmosphere.
There will be huge change in the vibrations also.
And spending in some time in nature, that's a complete different environment. It will be a cutoff,
yes,
and that will help you.
I read somewhere in one of the book called as Hands of Light and the Light Emerging by Barbara and Brennan during those days. Our aura will also change. Beautiful colors will come into our aura. If you spend some time with the animals, there will be some changes in aura. If you spend some time with trees and sunset, there will be some change in aura. If you listen to music by birds, there will be some change, development in aura. This is what has inspired me to spend time in nature. Changes in your aura will come, development in aura will come.
So you also wrote one book.
Yes.
Bhinnamga Alochinchu. It was in star. You wrote in Telugu,
yes,
and now it's been translated, I think, in Kannada.
Yes.
And now, very soon we'll get
it
in English.
It is going to be translated in English. Soon, and in another 1 or 2 months, it will come.
Okay.
In English.
So, what's the title, sir?
Think differently.
To
be happy anywhere, anytime.
Okay.
We have to be happy. Happiness should be choice. It should not be by chance. Sometimes we will be happy. Sometimes we will not be happy. No, we have to be happy every time, all the time. How you can be happy? By transforming yourself. But what is about the book?
Okay. And also you have done, you took many works in major pyramids like in Kartal. You were ground in charge for few years and you have taken up many works. And also we know more in Omkareshwara pyramid.
Yes.
And Omkareshwara pyramid, this is 150 kilometers away from Hyderabad city. And it is very much near, that is 90 kilometers drive from Srisailam, on the way to Srisailam. And in this pyramid, you took many, many groundworks. We know that pretty well. Many masters who are very senior in this society, they know that. And you have given your, you have put your heart and soul to in one line, I can tell you that. And beautifully have given designed garden, many flowers and, you know, lights, many things you have done, groundwork. And how is the experience?
See, any work is a teamwork. Any work whenever you do, you will be uplifted. Any work you do, you will get some challenges. You will get some problems. You will have to do many new works. Say, if you take Omkareshwara pyramid, earlier I never worked for gardens. That has a new work for me. So, I used to do a lot of research in internet and I used to go to many nurseries. I used to understand more about plantation, what kind of plant will be useful and where we have to plant it and what kind of stones we have to use. So, I learned the technology more completely about the plants. So, that is a learning for me. And the two in that rot environment like mountains and all, how we have to plant there, how we have to protect, how we have to give water to them. So, all these things and how we can beautify by keeping some different kinds of plant together and where you have to keep. So, lot of research I used, almost daily, almost 5 to 6 hours I used to spend internet, and based on the information I got in internet, I used to go to nurseries and I used to collect all the plants. That has changed me again. And when I am doing that work again, facing challenges with people, facing a lot of difference of opinions with the people, handling myself in those kind of disputes. See, everything is again a self transformation. There may be difference of opinions, there may be problems, there may be opposition, there may be challenges. In during those conditions, how you are able to manage? So, I try to manage myself, I try to learn new thought patterns also. I have learned about gardening beautifully, I learned about artwork, I never done artwork. I could find many people who are artists and with them I could do lot of artworks also there, which are all completely new works, but still, as I already told, natural intelligence. My natural intelligence helped me to do all these things. Earlier, I never done any kind of artwork or gardening work. So, I could understand that I can do anything. That confidence came to me because of this 4 to 5 years of work in Omkareshwara pyramid. I can say that now I can do anything because of this kind of works, because of successfully completing all this, beautifully completing all these works and comfortably facing all the challenges, comfortably facing challenges, happily doing all these works. That of course with the team, team is good. Vijayalakshmi madam helped me a lot, Srinivas Reddy sir, Vaidi Gupta garu and many other people are there who have helped me a lot, who worked along with me for all these great works, Srinivas garu, many people.
Coming to your book, can you share few excerpts from your book? What is this book all about?
It is completely about thoughts to be happy anywhere, anytime. Normally, we do everything for the sake of happiness only. We get married, we find a groom, right groom, good groom, and get married. Why we get married? To be happy, more happy. We'll find a beautiful girl and marry, to be happy. We go to a job and try to earn lot of money by doing a lot of business, to be happy. End of the day, the root cause behind every activity, whatever we are doing, is to be more and more happy. But by the end, we are not happy. We are losing our own happiness. We are searching for happiness. We are trying to be happy and we are losing happiness. We are born to be happy. We are not born to be unhappy. So, why we are not happy? Because we are following wrong thought patterns. negative thoughts or unscientific thoughts we are following. Because of unscientific and wrong thoughts, and we are not comfortable whatever we achieve, whatever we earn or whatever we do. So during this journey, how we have to think so that we can be more happy? That's what I try to explain. So last 26 years of my journey, I learned many thoughts through many books. I tried applied whatever I understood through all the books. So that I am trying to share out of my own experience. These are not new thoughts, I say. These are already existing thoughts. They are all there in many books, but in my own way, whichever helped me. I used to write initially one-line quotes in Telugu. They helped me, that course helped many people, and they came back to me, why don't you write a book by explaining this course. Then I started, I have written a book out of that course only. So almost 300 to 400 course out of 5000 course I have taken. So almost 5000 course I have written in Telugu. After that, I have taken 300 to 400 selected course related to different aspects of life. There will be family life, there will be success or failures in life, there will be thoughts patterns, there will be relationships. So on all these 18 different aspects of life, how you have to be in your thoughts, what kind of thoughts you have to choose so that you can be more happy. That is what is all about the Think Differently book. We are thinking like everybody in this world. We are thinking like our neighbors, we are thinking like our parents. What I say is, we should think like a yogi. Thinking like yogi is thinking differently. Thinking like world is as usual, will be suffering. Suffering should not be there. If you are suffering, that means there is some ignorance. You are following the world. You should follow a yogi. You should think like a yogi, then you can be happy. You should think like Vivekananda, you should think like Ramana Maharshi, you should think like Osho Rajneesh, you should think like Buddha, then you will be happy. If you think like any Bill Gates, if you think like Ambani or anybody, they are good, but you will not be happy. End of the day, you may get something, you may achieve some physical goals, social goals, but you will not be happy. Allow me thinking like Bill Gates or allow me thinking like any other businessman, you should think like a yogi also. We are missing this. Thinking like yogi is thinking differently.
So this reminds me of a story of Alexander and Diogenes.
Yes.
Where he said all these things.
Yes. Diogenes changed Alexander's thoughts.
Yes.
After thinking like Diogenes, Alexander left everything and shown his hands. Yes. He has changed his mindset. Even if he has conquered entire world, he was not happy. That's what he told. Conquering the world is of no use. Conquering yourself is more important than conquering the world. You will not be happy by conquering business, by conquering others, but by conquering yourself, you will be more happy. Thinking like Diogenes is thinking differently.
5000 of your thoughts or you know your own viewpoints, insights in this long journey, you took some important 300 to 400 quotes in that and you gave it all those you put in that book.
Give an explanation in different aspects of life.
Okay. Family, money, yes. You know, children, life, yes. Society, everything.
Correct. Correct.
All the aspects which every 18. Human being have.
Yes. 18 different aspects.
18 different. Yes. Like 18 guiding principles.
Correct.
Okay. Fine. So, very soon we will get this book in English too. We are eagerly waiting for that, sir. And we are very, very thankful to you. We came to know about, especially myself, I came to know about your journey and I'm very grateful to that. So this is what about a senior most master and his insights, his journey. We came to know that a master is the one who handles himself perfectly. He gives his best, not just in favorable conditions, also in unfavorable crisis, insult. It's all about handling himself perfectly. So next week we will meet another master. Thank you. Stay tuned to PMC English. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much for giving me opportunity. Special thanks to PMC English. Special thanks to our beloved Guruji Brahmashi Pitamaha Patriji.
Thank you, sir.